Hi everybody, it's Carol. Week one, seems like we were just doing week seven. This is OTL 5400. And I want to start by saying that in our last course, I had a chat, a Google Hangout chat with Dr. Langhorst, and I was on a rant about how the educational people, the PhDs in education, were grouping people into groups for group work, that they were applying Myers-Briggs to their groups. And I was saying, there's no way that this can happen in a 7-week course. And that's just ridiculous. That isn't going to happen. And of course, I was having nightmares in another class where I was in a group project that was not going well. And I would like to now say, Dr. Langhorst, you can have the last laugh. I was wrong. I thought the Edutopia inventory was excellent. It was very short. If I were teaching an online class, I would use it because I think that it would be a good way to group people. And for me personally, it was spot on. It actually got my learning profile correctly, I thought. I determined that I am linguistic and that I'm interested in relationships, both intra and interpersonal. I had well over 50% on each of those categories, and I would say that's completely who I am. I did have a high score on naturalistic, which made me smile. There was a question on gardening, which I know that I answered that I would never want to do because that's not something that I enjoy. But I had one, there was a question on, do you think of nature? And so I said, oh, a lot, because I think about going to the beach a lot because I love to go to the beach. And so what I think about is the water and the horizon and the waves and the sound and all of that. But I envision that sitting in the sand on a beach chair under umbrella with a cold beverage and a good book, not really naturalistic in my opinion, which I think of as roughing it, but I'll take that if that's what it is. So anyway, I really liked that test and I would use that actually very, I would definitely use that. The second test was VARC. I did not care for that test as much. It did tell me though that I have a mild read-write learning preference and I think that's accurate. I felt there was test bias, I guess, because I didn't think that the questions were ones that interested me. The activities were not ones that interested me, like buying a computer game or understanding my cell phone or buying a digital camera. So when it came down to choosing answers, I just picked the lesser of evils and moved on. So I don't think I cared that much about what my answers were, but it did seem to figure out who I was as far as my learning style, but I liked that test the least. The ILS test I thought was a good test in that I did feel like it picked my learning preferences. I thought it seemed balanced. I did think it was interesting that they seemed to have safeguards built in where I could answer a question one way and then I felt like I was answering the same question, but I was giving a different answer. And then when I got my score, I really did feel like it was correct. So an example of that was it asked, do you like to learn facts or do you like to learn theories? And so in one question, I said, yes, I like to learn facts. And I thought, well, that's true. I like objective quizzes and that sort of thing. But then I also said that I like to learn theories, which is also true because I like to learn things like themes and literary terms and so on and how they apply to real world. And so in the end, it came down to I was very across the board, very even, right down the middle on all of the areas, active reflective and sensing intuitive and visual verbal were all right in the very middle. I did think that on the active reflective that when it's too reflective for me in online learning, I just get on and post a bunch. So that's how I make my online experience active. On the sequential global, that was the one category where I had a stronger preference in the sequential area. And so I determined from that, which is true about me, that I'm sort of a plotter. I like things to go in line. I like to know the steps of things. And I think that I have a harder time seeing the big picture unless I know the steps. And I started thinking about this from a teaching viewpoint, and I think that that's probably a trait that a lot of teachers have, because you have to be able to see the parts of a lesson plan, for instance, and you have to be able to explain the parts. So from that standpoint, I think it's probably a good trait for a teacher. And I'm not saying that that's good about me necessarily, but I'm just saying that that may be something that teachers will find that they have in common. Maybe not. I also did, of course, the required reading, and I did some of the supplemental things as well. The one video, though, that I do want to comment on was what is active learning. And I liked that because I thought it was really basic in that it defined what active learning is, but I liked the statistics that sort of hit you over the head that said that you remembered 90% of what you do and 10% of what you read. And I thought, if you're not on board with providing active learning opportunities for students after hearing that, then you, I don't know, I guess maybe you're in a bubble, but really that's something that we should very much consider. So I'll be anxious to hear your videos, and I'm glad we're in class together again. So I'll see you in the forums.